Hi there, let's look at another challenging problem sum on fraction. And this question is from a past PSLE paper. Mrs. Hoon made some cookies to sell. 3/4 of them were chocolate cookies and the rest were almond cookies. After selling 210 almond cookies and 5/6 of the chocolate cookies, she had 1/5 of the cookies left. How many cookies did Mrs. Hoon sell? Alright, so let's draw a table over here. Alright, we have a C for chocolate, A for almond, and total over here. And then we have before, change, and after. Okay, so at first, 3/4 were chocolate. So can you make a guess, what's the ratio over here? Right, the answer is 3:1:4. Okay, because out of 4 units, 3 were chocolate, and 1 is almond. Okay, and now, the question says that she's going to sell 5/6 of the chocolate cookies. Okay, so out of 6 units of chocolate cookies, she's going to sell 5 of them. Okay, so to do this, right, we can actually times 2 over here, okay, to make the ratio 6:2:8. And why do we do that? That's because we want to make the starting cookies to be 6 units. Okay, you know why, right? Because it's going to sell 5/6 of the chocolate cookies. So we make the starting chocolate cookies to be 6 units. Okay, and now let's apply the change. Alright, so out of the 6 units, the chocolate is going to sell 5 units away. Then for the almond, he's going to sell 210 away. And now look at the total cookies. In the end, Mrs. Hoon had 1/5 of the cookies left. So to find the cookies left, you need to take 8 units times 1/5. Okay, does it make sense? Okay, look carefully, okay? The question says that she had 1/5 of the cookies left. This 1/5 is of the total cookies. Alright? So 1/5 times 8 unit, you'll get the cookies left over. Okay? So 6 unit minus 5 unit, you get 1 unit. Okay, so this for the chocolate left. Then for the total, 8 units times 1/5, you get 1.6 units. Right, do not worry for decimals, okay? Right, sometimes units can have decimals in front. And now, to find the almond, what do? You simply take this minus this. Right, you get 0.6 units. Does it make sense? Right, because if Mrs. Hoon had 1.6 units of cookies in the end, alright, and she has a 1 unit of chocolate in the end, so the almond will be 1.6 minus 1, which is 0.6 units. Alright, and now how do we find 1 unit? Okay, let's look at the almond over here. At first, the almond has 2 units, in the end has 0.6 units, so the difference will be 1.4 units. Does it make sense? And this 1.4 units will be equals to 210, right, because she sells 210 almond cookies. Alright, so to find 1 unit, you take 210 divided by 1.4, you get 150. And now the question asks, how many cookies did she sell? Alright, you need to take 150 times 5, then plus 210. Okay, so this will be the total cookie that she sell, which is 960. Okay, and of course, instead of doing by this way, you can also take 4/5 times 8 unit. Right, because she has a 1/5 of the cookies left, means she sell 4/5 of the 8 units. Okay, so we'll take 8 times 150, then times 4/5, you should also get the same answer of 960.